a horizontal shift. This is also a slide, but this slide moves either left or right, so right or left. It preserves the shape of a graph. It just literally slides left or right. So what does that look like? Well, we have y equals f, but we're going to take the x value and we're going to either say minus a value c, or we're going to take the x value and on the inside of the grouping symbol of the function notation, it's going to look like x plus c. So it's a little confusing when we do a horizontal shift because we simplify the operations. So I'm also going to write y equals f of x minus a negative c, and I'll clarify why in just a moment. So I want you to notice, though, that the addition or the subtraction is inside the function notation. In other words, it's something that's happening to the x in those grouping symbols. So I'll say inside the grouping symbol. Okay, so the only thing that happens here then is something happens to the x value of the key points of your parent graph. So we're going to either add or subtract c to the x values of key points. That's the action taken. Now, let's look at when we have this, y equals f of x minus c. Well, c is actually a positive value. So it's like the formula has subtraction in it when we're talking about a horizontal shift. So when we have this, y equals f of x minus c, this is a shift right. Okay? And to move right on a graph, you know you have to add c to the x values. Now, when we have y equals f of x plus c, which remember you can think about as being f of x minus a negative c, well, there's a negative number being subtracted, so the operation simplifies to looking like f of x plus c, but this is a shift left. And just think, if you move left on a number line, you subtract c to the x values. So when you have a horizontal shift, you either add or subtract a value to the x's inside the grouping symbol, inside whatever you identify as the parent function. And it's almost like it's the opposite of what you want to do. So let's once again look at, sorry about that, look at the absolute value function. So we're looking at our V curve here. And the three key points that we're going to always use to identify the shape of the absolute value are the origin, 1, 1, and negative 1, 1. That gives us the V-shaped curve. Let me change colors. I don't know, green, I guess. Let's say I want to graph y equals the absolute value of x plus 2. This could also be thought of as the absolute value of x minus a negative 2. So this is a shift left. So we're going to subtract 2 units from the x values of the parent graph's key points. So I'm going to take the origin. The x value is 0. I'm going to subtract 2. So I'd be here at negative 2, 0. I'm going to take negative 1 and subtract 2, so I'd be at negative 3, but nothing happens to the y value. So I leave that as a 1. And then for the parent key point of 1, 1, I'm just going to subtract 2 from 1 and get negative 1. And then I'll also be at positive 1, so my shape's not perfect or my scale's not great, but I'll be at the point negative 1, 1 for the green function. That is the function y equals the absolute value of x plus 2. I'm going to change colors again. Now I want to graph y equals the absolute value of x minus 1. Oops. Me straighten up that absolute value symbol because it kind of looks like a parenthesis. So this is of the form y equals f of x minus c, so my c happens to be the positive value of 1, so this is a shift right. So what's going to happen is I'm going to add 1 to all the x values. So the origin would move to 1, 0. The point 1, 1 would move to 2, 1. And the point negative 1, 1 from the parent graph would move to 0, 1. And then again, other than due to freehanding this, whoa, where did it go? Sorry about that. We would show that the graph of y equals x minus 1, the absolute value of x minus 1, is this blue V-shaped curve where the key points have moved to 0, 1, 1, 0, and 2, 1.